Hey folks, welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's tools, tips, and talk, where we'll discuss info for the knife maker. Well folks, I am in full swing on my build for the Samurai Challenge. And if you're not sure what that is, there's a link up in the corner for you to go check out the Samurai Challenge, which will be coming next month in October. I'll be making a katana for the Samurai Challenge, and that's what I'm working on. One of the issues that I wanted to do is put a fuller in that katana. But of course, the katana is curved. Yeah, I could have put the fuller in by grinding it, but I actually wanted it very precise and crisp. When I put fullers in blades, I typically use my mill and I use a ball end mill. And I wanted to be able to do that with the katana, but it's curved and I don't have a CNC mill. So I want to show you guys the method that I came up with in order to put that fuller in. Let's go take a look. So I thought I'd start with a picture on what I'm trying to accomplish. So I'm trying to get a fuller, which is, you know, some call it a blood groove, but really a fuller in the spine of the blade that is, sorry for the squeak, something like this. Okay, about 3/8 wide in the top of the blade. The problem is, since this is curved and I have just a regular mill, if I lock the blade in the mill, then I have to do all these kind of like step adjustments, and I'm doing it with manual wheels. It's really hard to get a curve like this. Really, really hard. If it was a CNC mill, you could just program this curve. It would take you a really long time, but you could probably just have it mill that. So what are the alternatives? So yes, I could put a small wheel in my grinder and just kind of sit the blade on the rest. And then as I move the blade, it would kind of center up and do a groove. So I kind of use that principle, but I'm going to use it on the mill. So what I've done, and you'll see this on the mill, is I basically, if we're looking straight down on the table, I put a stop, basically two stops that are bolted to the table. Okay, so these are basically just kind of round pivot points bolted to the table. They're 2 inches apart. Then I'm going to take the blade, put it up against those, do a 2-inch section, and then, of course, the blade is bolted down and against those two. Then I'm going to take this blade, move it 2 inches, bolt it back, and do another one. So what I'm going to end up having is kind of a straight line, but they're so close that it should be pretty smooth and I'll be able to fix it up after. Let's go take a look on the mill. I also want to mention our channel sponsor, Maritime Knife Supply. If you need anything knife related, whether it's steel, ferrochloride, handle material, spacers, you name it, epoxy, anything you need for knife making, check out Maritime Knife Supply. The link's down in the description. You can shop in US dollars, take advantage of that US to Canadian exchange rate. They have quick shipping as fast as any of the other US sites, so go check them out. Okay folks, here is the setup. So I've made these two, I just turned these two things on the lathe so they're nice and smooth. I could have used anything, but I wanted something that was perfectly round. So these two, let's call them pins, are locked in place, and they're parallel. In fact, even if they're not parallel, it doesn't really matter. The spine of the blade is locked up against these two. Then I have a ball end mill, which I'm gonna plunge, do 2 inches of cutting, okay, then raise it, move it along. I'm gonna unclamp these, move the sword down 2 inches. Again, it'll be up against the pins, okay? So I know that my line will be equidistant from the top of the spine. And then this will just take into account the curvature of the blade. I figured 2 inches was good enough that you're not going to notice It doesn't curve that much that you're going to notice, the 2-inch, the change in angle here. Now, after it's hand sanded, I don't think you'll see this at all. So that's what we're going to do. This should involve, I'm going to do it about 20 or 22 inches, so it'll mean 9 or 10 moves. Let's give it a shot. So here I'm using a 1/2-inch ball end mill. It's not a brand new mill, so plunging with this thing gave me a little bit of a problem, so I did have to kind of go back and forth, which took a little bit. But when I got to the right depth, which was just more than a 1/16 of an inch, then I can make passes and go back and forth. You'll also notice that I removed my vise from the table, so I have this blade clamped securely down onto the table, just so there was no chatter and it didn't move. So here's the blade after machining in the fuller. You can see that every 2 inches, I'll zoom in a bit here, there is a little start and stop. And of course that's because where the pins are, every 2 inches we would move it a little bit. So of course the end points give this little issue. But we're going to fix that. How? We're going to use one of these. So this is just a sanding drum on a Dremel, and we're just going to take it and go down like this, and that should smooth it out. This process took me about maybe 1/2 hour to get both sides done. So just a little info about doing this. When you turn these on, what I'm doing is I'm actually putting a finger on either side of the blade just to steady it. And these things will, it's spinning this way, it's tending, it wants to suck into this side. So you do this side, and then I'm going to flip the blade over and do the bottom side just to get a nice even bevel. And now I move to hand sanding. I wrapped a piece of 220 around a 1/2-inch bar and just use that to sand the fuller to get it nice and crisp. So here is the end result. You can see that the fuller just looks nice and smooth and very crisp. The edges of it are just really, really nice. And this is after it's been sanded to 400. I'm really happy with it. So really happy with that process. Worked out great. So consider this if you guys are doing a tough fuller on a curved blade. This will give you some tips on how to do it. Stay tuned to see the rest of this build, this katana build, as part of the Samurai Challenge. Thanks, folks. We'll see you in the next one.